I'm a dude playing a dude disguised as another dude.
Hello, collectors, and welcome to the Discount Action Figure Dude. I am your host, Christopher, and as you can clearly see, we are still at the hangout of Team Cobra as they are just chilling, doing Team Cobra things, waiting for a new member of the team to show up, and that new member of the team would be the Crocmaster and Fiona. Now, we got this figure at the infamous Ross's Dress for Less, as you can plainly see, for $11.99. As a collector, you've seen the videos of people, of various YouTubers talking about Ross's. To be completely honest with you, I have a Ross's nearby. Even though I am the Discount Action Figure Dude, I am really not one for toy hunting. That doesn't really interest me. I have been to Ross's maybe 3 or 4 times in the last 4 months. Now, I do go to Ollie's a lot, but that's because Ollie sells a lot of other things that I buy, like Keurig cups and Ziploc bags and crazy glue and pots, pans, minced garlic. They have a lot of things, which is why I am a 3-star general at Ollie's. Ross's, on the other hand, if I go to a Ross's, I'm going for one reason, and that is to look for toys. I have enough clothes, so I don't need them to dress for less. But this is interesting. So the story is, it's a few days after Christmas. I don't know when you're going to see this video. I probably won't post it until sometime after the new year. But for Christmas, I went to Mississippi to visit my father. I told my wife and my son, who came down from Chicago to visit and to see his grandfather, that since I'm going to be in a different state, I'm going to go to some Ross's. They said, okay, that's cool. Until, of course, they realized that I was going to go to every Ross's in Mississippi. Well, not in Mississippi, in Jackson, which was like 3 Ross's. Okay, just 3. It was 3. It wasn't every Ross's. But I did go to a couple of Ross's in Mississippi. And I think each Ross's I went to was kind of fruitful. And mind you, on the few times I've gone to Ross's, it's been kind of a smorgasbord for me. I've managed to pick up a few things here and there. Another thing I might say about me and just Discount Action Figures in general at Ross's, albeit at Ollie's, when I was at Ross's, they had maybe 6 of these. How many did I buy? 1. Because I only need 1. I am not a reseller. I can't army build Croc and Fiona. So therefore, I leave them there for the next guy. I'm not greedy. I'm not trying to take things. I just needed 1. There was also a Barbecue Kelly and the Sailor Dude, who I can't remember his name, but we're going to do a Discount Action Figure review on him too. I just want to say that I only took 1. Leave some for the next guy. If that's some commie thinking, I apologize, but I am not trying to take everything from everybody. Leave some for the next guy. I'm a firm believer in leaving some for other people. Anyway, all of that rigmarole aside, let's say we cut this bitch open. And here goes Crocmaster and Fiona out of the box, surrounded by all of their stuff. And I can tell you already that for $12, this is most certainly a raw dog value. If only Hasbro showed the kind of love to their Marvel Legends line that they show to their G.I. Joe Classified lines. The G.I. Joe Classified lines gets all kinds of cool, great stuff. I get it. It's a licensing thing. Maybe Disney should make their own toys, or maybe cut the price so that the Marvel Legends line can get more love, more affection. But I often wonder, how good can the G.I. Joe classified lines be moving when, you know, their stuff is at, you know, Ross's for $12 and Ollie's for $5 or whatever. Nonetheless, that's neither here nor there. That's just the prattlings of an old man. Let's say we take a closer look at Croc-Master and Fiona. Croc-Master, yeah, this guy strikes me as the dude, even amongst a crew of murderers, killers, and thugs that nobody wants to hang out with. He looks like he is absolutely no fun to hang out with. Croc-Master, in addition to his alligator, he comes with some accessories such as his knife, which goes in his thing right there, and he has his gun, which goes in his holster right here, if we can put it in there. He also comes with a whip, which looks very good. I don't think Fiona's going to like that particular accessory of his. He also comes with a looks like a hook of some kind. I am not sure what he uses this for, but I'm sure he can't possibly use it, Fiona. And of course, we, you know, a couple of baby crocs to go along with us. Taking a closer look at Croc-Master as he lets go of Fiona. We've got to admit, Croc-Master wearing his Cobra logo and his mask. He looks very, very good. He is very detailed. Nice. He has no backpack, thank goodness. We don't like those on our classifieds. They're useless. I'm sorry, Croc-Master, but you're the Croc-Master. Your best friend is clearly a crocodile, and yet you're wearing, unless that's a gator vest, it's a crocodile vest. It looks like you got a crocodile eye there, too. Not to mention a crocodile codpiece. I mean, you know, you're showing Fiona no respect here, my brother. You're showing Fiona no respect here. Let's take a closer look at Fiona, though. So Fiona is a surprisingly well-articulated gator. She can move her legs back and forth, up and down, both her rear and her forward legs. Her tail rotates quite well. Her head moves up and down. And most importantly, Fiona's mouth opens. Look at that. Look at that. Again, like I said, for $12, it's an insane value, but for the original price of $40, yeah, I can see where one would charge that and one would pay for that. I mean, if Fiona herself is a really impressive figure, you know, I mean, this is a wonderful gator. This is a wonderful crocodile. Fiona, come on now. Do you care about the articulation of Croc-Master? You probably don't. Fiona's the star of this show, but Croc-Master can articulate too. He doesn't need to do anything, really, except, you know, take care of Fiona. But he has double-jointed stuff. He can do stuff. His head tilts back, forward, up, and he has ab crunch. He can do all the things that we expect from a G.I. Joe classified to do. But his main job is to look after Fiona, even though he's disrespecting Fiona by wearing, you know, a crocodile vest, a crocodile eye, and a crocodile codpiece. I think that's just, you know, highly disrespectful, Croc-Master. We already told you what kind of value that Croc-Master and Fiona is. It's a raw dog value. Again, I don't go to Ross's often, but on this occasion, visiting my old dude in Mississippi, much to the chagrin of my son and my wife, who were dragged along to the Ross's in Mississippi. I mean, we had nothing else to do, quite honestly. If we were there for 3 days, what else are we going to do? Ross's came through with a great set in Fiona and Croc-Master, because we're switching it around. It's all about Fiona.